Today I'm going to show you how to make skateboarding videos and the gear you need for under $500, and also how to edit it and make it look like the old school OG skateboarding videos, because I think it's a cool special effect. So it's a two-in-one here. So let's have a look at the rig here. Alrighty, so as I'm editing this video, I realized it got sort of long, so I'm going to make this real simple for you guys. So if you want to watch a whole thing, it has a bit of vlogging in it, whole experience, just continue watching the video. But if you came here just for the skateboarding setup, you want to know what it is? Go to this time right here. And if you want to watch just a tutorial, go to this time right here. So yeah. So this rig is made up of four components. So starting with the camera, we got for the body, the Canon Rebel T3i. Next, for the lens, we have the Canon 10 to 18mm lens. For the mic, we have the Rode Video Micro mic. Finally, for the rig, we have this weird looking C-shaped thing that's a camera stabilizer, and it's fairly cheap, 20 bucks. And it gets the job done. This is gonna be around $500, but if you dig deep and find those bargains, you can get it for way cheaper. I got all this stuff for way cheaper than the prices I showed you. Yo, what up?
Where you at?
I'm about to come over. I haven't told you this yet, but I'm using you as my stunt, and I'm making a tutorial out of you.
What?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you're just my fucking subject. I'm using you for your skateboarding capabilities. All right, I'm hurrying my ass up. Peace out.
Peace.
All right, yeah, so that was my friend. Actually, I haven't told you guys this, but I'm going over to his house. He's going to be my stunt man. He's recently just got back into skateboarding, and we're just going to fuck around. I'm going to film him. I'm going to show you how this baby works, and once I record the footage, I'm going to go into Final Cut, and I'm going to show you how I edit it and make it look old school, and basically, I think it looks cool. So, yeah, let's go do that. Tripping on back from the legs, hey, son. Never tell a pack that I never stay running. Sipping on facts, damn, no, I got stacks in the lab. Taking bitches straight for another cat. Make shit while I never had shit. Bitch, move, make your motherfucking head split. Cost to the loss, never really gon' pay shit. Tell me, never really gon' chase it. Yeah. I realize the car I'm driving doesn't have a license plate. My car's actually in the shop, but. Alright, my friend that lives here, he's moving over there right now. I'm about to help him carry some stuff.
Aw, look who it is.
Yep. Clayton been showing Randy how to move furniture.
Oh, yeah.
Clay told me you guys needed someone who could lift a lot.
Would you like
Why Cam?
Come with me real quick and I'll clean this up.
Alright, we're about to go check out the new apartment. This is Skater, by the way. Yep. Let's see it.
Here we go.
I'm trying to scratch.
I'm going to miss the 21.
21.
Basically, it's more or less the same with minus a room.
So. Oh. Looks like I'm door bitch. My job is to hold the door right now. Let's see how this one works out.
But I'm doing it anyway.
Yeah. She's here. Thumbnail.
Thumbnail?
What is thumbnail?
We're going to have to do that outside.
Oh, yeah.
Chief. Wait, this is your car.
My car's fucked up.
Oh, because you got into the wreck.
Hey, he into the wreck.
She's starting a conversation.
Hell yeah.
Wait, so how did you get into the wreck?
I was waving at a girl and got distracted and fucking...
It's always the girls.
Always the girls.
Got the rig out here, about to film, and real quick, a few quick tips. Rolling on the board, more stable footage so you're not running. You're rolling. That's number one. And then tip number two, keep it low. This is a really wide lens. You can get really up close. So low, up close. Looks fantastic. Fucking beautiful. All right, you ready?
Yep.
Let me see if my settings are good. Camera died, but the good news is we're getting up bright and early. We'll actually have some daylight, so we'll continue this tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow.
Will you be here?
Yep, bright and early.
Here we are, next day. Brought my fellow skaters. Going over there.
Oh! Sorry. I didn't get it.
What up? Hey, what the fuck's up? Oh, yeah. I'm in a rowdy ass club, there's hella bitches all around me. This girl walks up, she says she glad that she found me. I told her she was tripping cause the girl ain't even know me. Then she told me, she wanna introduce me to her homie. I said, well baby girl, go get your chemotopies. I'll get my liquid niggas, we'll meet you in the lobby. She walk with a smile, I ain't seen in a while. So we fly through the crowd, kill a cow style. Walk up with a left, cause see we pimp to perfection. For us to catch a date, don't take the love connection. Fuck your booty, you wanna date for sure. All it take is fly jewelry. A wink and a drink and what the fuck you think. I'm like a baby dog down, seeing a lone black man. We straight standing in the lobby, straight face to face. This he said, cut the chase, let's bounce to my place. Cause
you see what I was saying?
Next time I come down here and bring my own shampoo, conditioner, all that fucking shit. It's just so stupid.
These motherfuckers pay good money to hop up on a thing and fucking pedal around town.
Hey! Hey!
What the fuck is that?
Hey, what's that ass like? Yo! Hey, y'all drunk as fuck? Hey! Are y'all drunk as fuck?
We were probably pissing off too. So good.
Yeah. Did I decide on you not filming?
No,
yeah.
Film.
Yeah.
Asshole shit right here, man.
I can't fucking believe this asshole. He didn't even slam this fucking Tacoma.
Thank you.
Maybe I did.
This way,
this
way.
Back in the car.
Terrific day.
Terrific day.
Hot as fuck.
Fucking.
Now it's cool.
Oh, yeah, fantastic.
It's hot as fuck all day though.
We got here steaming.
Here we are. The camera's just been sent by the subwoofers. Whoa, subwoofer. Whoa. Camera's been sent by the subwoofers. We're done now.
Hey, key's not working. Good thing German engineering is, you know.
Yep. Well, that's why it ain't working.
Okay, well, we've had a really fun day today skating in Nashville, and I don't know what the fuck he did that for. Thank you. He's pointing shit at me. But yeah, I'll see y'all when I see you.
When are you gonna see him next?
Whenever you put me in another video.
Hello you guys, so you want to make skate videos and or achieve this old school film look. That's why you clicked the video and I'm about to show you how to do that. Let's start with the gear needed or recommended to make skate videos. Now I do go more in depth at the beginning of the video, but here's a quick summary. Starting off with the body, we have the Canon Rebel T3i body. Next for the lens, we have the Canon 10-18mm lens. Third, we have the Rode Video Micro Mic. After that, we have our camera stabilizer, and lastly, a big SD card. Here's why I like this setup so much. So, it's widely regarded as the cheapest, most ideal, high-quality setup on the market. The Canon Rebel T3i and models similar are regarded as being famous almost in the video world. They're just great starter DSLRs, and people love them for their video capabilities. The interface is very easy and simple to use, and most importantly, just produces good video for the price. One of my favorite things about this camera is that the T3i has this third-party software you can download called Magic Lantern, and it essentially makes the camera perform like a $1,000-$2,000 camera. It gives it all these crazy features and really just helps you expand your video making capabilities. Next, with the lens, I am in love with the 10-18mm lens. It used to be my go-to lens when this was my everyday setup. It is the cheapest, most high-quality wide-angle lens on the market. It also has image stabilization, which is incredibly important for video. Now, the reason why this wide-angle lens is great for the setup is because when you're filming skateboarding, one, the image stabilization helps, you know, make that footage less shaky because essentially you're on a skateboard most of the time, following behind them, recording them, and there's some shakiness or whatever. So it counteracts that a bit. Also, the wideness of the lens really helps you get the whole skater in frame because it's sort of hard to predict movements at certain times. So that's very useful. And lastly, when you hold the lens low to the ground, get that low angle, it makes a skateboarder's tricks look bigger, faster, and just better in general. This lens just does a great job at getting that skateboard look. And although it's not a fisheye, a lot of skaters use it in the community today. Let's talk audio for a minute. So audio is just a crucial element in making any kind of high quality video, just plain and simple. And external mics may not be the best, but they're very convenient and portable, and they really do get the job done. And this one more specifically really does perform well. It's not a hassle, and it's the cheapest on the market. Stabilizer. So this stabilizer, $20. The price is just unbeatable. Now, compared to most stabilizers, which are anywhere from a few $100s to a few $1,000s, this stabilizer is just so worth it for the price. And it's a lot easier to use than the other ones. Most stabilizers, you have to sit there, balance, they're a pain to carry around, they're a pain to balance every second. This one, you literally screw the camera in, you're good to go. Now, the footage isn't gonna be as smooth and steady as a lot of the most high-end ones, but at the same time, you're paying $20, so. Lastly, a big SD card is just crucial in my opinion, and I have a lot of reasons for that. So starting off, skaters are trying to always push their limits on camera. They're trying to get the best trick, trying to make it look the cleanest, and this can take them many different tries, try after try. And you always want to be recording and be ready for the shot. So having a big SD card that allows you to always be ready to record to get the shot really helps. And a lot of times I found that I was recording, you know, 20, 30 minutes at a time, and that takes up a lot of space. So moving to different spots, always recording, not missing any moments, not missing any potential clips is just very important in my opinion, and a big SD card really helps you with that. All right, now you know about the setup. Here's an example of some raw footage, no color correction, no nothing. Raw footage, raw audio with this setup. So check it out.
We headed to,
it's that way.
Yeah.
Now, moving on to the second thing I want people to get out of this video is achieving that old school look in Final Cut Pro. Now, before we move on with the tutorial, I think it's necessary to sort of understand some background information regarding these old school cameras and whatnot. There is a camera called the Sony VX1000 that is considered legendary due to its look and its capabilities at the time it was released. The handle and shape of this camera made it seem as if it was just designed to film skateboarding. It was the perfect skateboarding camera. The colors and resolution of this camera captured an era of skateboarding that heavily influenced how people skate today. It's super interesting because this camera is almost like an artifact of the skateboarding culture and is still valued today greatly. If you've seen an old skateboarding video, it was most likely filmed with this camera. Now, there was newer models that were released and there were some competitors, but this was like the go-to camera for skateboarding. The look I've been talking about is not the exact look as a VHS look, but it's pretty similar. And you can, of course, tweak anything I show you and make it fulfill your needs. So let's get into it. Alrighty, so now we're in Final Cut Pro. The first step is we're going to import our footage. I have my clip right here, this clip I'm going to be working on. So now we're gonna wanna modify our project settings. This is first thing we need to do. So I'm gonna press Command J, come over here to modify, turn the video custom, make the resolution 640 by 480. Okay, and then the frame rate, this frame rate works for me because that's what I shot it in. So yeah, you'll notice the bars there. That's good. That's what we want. And some of you guys, you may have black bars up here, and to fix that, you have to come over here, and instead of fit, you put it on fill, and then that will solve that problem. Alrighty, so now let's get into the effects here. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna drag and drop all the effects I'm about to post on the screen onto the clip, and you'll find these effects right over here in your effects tab. Alright, so here are our effects. So we have our blur right here. You're gonna drag and drop that in and put it on 3. Next, you have your noise, and I like putting it on TV static and making the amount around this. Of course, you can tweak it. That goes with all these. And then we'll come back to color correction later. But for the bad TV effect, this you can really play with. I really like it at around 1.5, 1.4. And for the roll, I really like the negative 2 as well. And you can play with this and keyframe it for transitions as well. That's something else I haven't really seen people do, but it's a cool transition. Oh yeah, and the static blend mode screen is a great option for that. And something crucial is the sharpen effect, which you'll find right down here, of course. You want to make sure that's on top of all the other effects. That's something very important. All right, so now I'm going to go through, add all these effects to this clip right here, and I'll come back. Alrighty, so I have all the effects done. Now let's go into color correction. So the way I like to do this is I select my clip, come over here, show color board. Alrighty, so the exposure varies clip to clip. You can do whatever you want with that. But the saturation, this is where things start to get important. So we're gonna add saturation in the highlights and decrease saturation in the shadows. And we're also going to make the clip either too warm or too cool, because VHS cameras and cameras like the Sony VX1000, they would have this problem where the white balance would always be screwed up. It would either be way too warm or way too cool. So we're going to sort of mimic that by making the global either too warm or too cool. This particular clip, I'm going to go too warm. Alrighty, now that that's done, we're gonna mess with the audio now. This part is really cool. Alrighty, I'm gonna go ahead and turn my audio back up for this clip. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over to effects, all video and all audio. Come over to distortion, and we're gonna add this car radio effect. Now this, again, it's personal preference, but I'm gonna go over to the audio right here and put it at 40. So yeah, let's take a listen to it before the effect. Alrighty, and now let's turn on this car radio effect, and yeah, let's take a listen. So the mics on these old cameras were not too spectacular, but this effect really brings out and makes the clip seem authentic, like it was recorded on one of these old cameras. I love that effect. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and render this out, and yeah, let's see how it looks. Hey! All right, so last thing I wanna show you guys is this really cool font I found. All right, here's a font. It's called VCR OSD Mono. So with this font, I see on a lot of old VHS films, they'll have a date on the left, bottom left side of the screen. So you can do that. This is optional, but I think this text just sort of helps add like a cool little theme to the video. And you can play with it, get creative. I really like it. I got this font from this website, and I'll link it down in the description below if you're interested. So there it is. Now, real quick, once again, tweaking these effects for your original vision of the video will significantly increase the results of the outcome. You can do whatever you want with this. Get creative. Trust me. Don't just do exactly what I did, because I was filming under different circumstances. It's all situational. Alrighty. But anyways, done with this video. Thank you so much for watching. Look who came over. Yeah, baby. Thank you so much. Please drop a like, subscribe. Appreciate it. Have a great day. Peace out. Hit the stage, hit my voodoo walk, got my polo socks.